Good afternoon, everyone. So I am Subhadip Sahu, and today I am going to talk about Hart Communication Protocol. Okay. So Hart Communication is basically Hart stands for Highway Addressable Remote Transducer. Okay. Before I start, I want you to think something basic. Suppose you have a mobile phone. Okay. But using this mobile phone, we can only make the phone calls. You can't do messaging. You can't watch video. You can't listen to the music. So, if your mobile is only designed for the phone call, then there is a huge loss of efficiency, right? And also, if your mobile is smart device, then it will not be called as smart device if you only do the phone calls using your mobile. So in our new era, we are going to be smart more and more, and we already have proven some smart devices, and we have already made some smart devices. So this Hart Communication Protocol is basically made for some smart devices, and let's start. So today I am going to talk about what is Hart Communication Protocol, then how does it work, then the benefits of the Hart Communication, then the configuration of the devices, then the wireless Hart overview, and how does it work, and the application of the wireless Hart. Okay, so what is Hart? So basically, Hart is a global standard for sending and receiving digital information across analog wires between smart devices or control monitor system. So in Hart Communication, there will be one master device and there will be one slave device. Okay, this master device is called as a host device, and this slave device is called as a field device. Okay, this master device will send the command to the slave, and the slave will respond to the command, and it will send the data to the master according to the command. Okay, and this Hart protocol is designed as a two-way communication. Before that, we had only one-way communication. The masters give the commands to the slave, and slave does it work. But in this case, slave will also send the data to the masters. So this is two-way communication protocol. Okay. Now coming to the working principle. Here you can see the working principle of Hart Communication Protocol. There is one red line and there is some blue line. Okay. This red line is an analog signal, and this blue line, that is a PSK digital signal. Okay. Suppose there is a sensor. Basically, Hart Communication Protocol works with the smart sensors like temperature sensors and pressure sensors like that. And there is one transducer. There will be one transducer. Which is connected with the smart sensors. And this transducer will convert the data of the smart sensors to the analog signal or analog data. Okay, this analog signal is basically made for getting the data from the transducer, and it will send the data to the master's device, that is host. Okay, and suppose we have a temperature sensor. The range of the temperature sensor is from 0 degree centigrade to 100 degree centigrade. It can sense from 0 degree to 100 degree centigrade. Okay, suppose it can sense 50 degree centigrade, then it will convert the temperature into 10 milliampere, and it will send the analog signal to the host. And this analog signal, range of the analog signal is 4 milliampere to 20 milliampere. Okay. There is a conventional way of getting this 4 milliampere to 20 milliampere smart devices. And after that, we can see there is digital signal. Using this analog signal, we will get our primary data from the field devices to the host devices. But Then what is the means of this digital communication? Because we are getting the data from the field devices by using the analog signal. This is the beauty of Hart Communication. Using this analog signal, we only get the primary data. But using the digital signal, we'll get the signal, we'll get the status of the field devices. Also, we can monitor the status of the field devices and the performance of the field devices we can get using this PSK digital signal. And this is the low level modulation, and we use FSK signal to modulate it. Okay. So, and this digital signal and analog signal can be combined together, and it will not interfere each other. And this can be sent using one twisted wire, using one pair of twisted wire. Okay. And this is the beauty of Hart Communication. We can use both digital signal and analog signal together. So now I'll show there is two way of communication. One is point to point connection for Hart Communication, and another is multi-rope connection. It is one picture of point to point connection. This is intelligent Hart device, and this is a Hart enabled IO. It can be a PC, it can be a PLC, it can be a laptop also. Here you can see this is directly connect with the Hart devices, intelligent Hart devices, and it will send the command to the Hart device, and the Hart device will work according to the command, and it will send the data back to the host. So this is point to point, and if we use a multiplexer, then we can use many Hart devices together using one address. Okay. Now coming to the this is another mode of point to point connection. Here you can see in Hart Communication protocol we can use two masters, maximum two masters. One is the primary master and there is secondary masters. And primary master is basically you can use a PC in a control room or laptop in a control room. But there is another secondary master is that is handheld terminal. A handheld terminal, it can be moved into the field devices, and it can be connect. You can take it into the field, and you can connect it with the field devices there. And you can take the data from the field devices by connecting like this. So this is not removable. It can be removable. Okay, and it is temporary, and it is the primary master, and it is permanent. Now coming to the second configuration, that is multi-rope configuration. I have already talked about the point-to-point connection, and this is the multi-rope connection. Using multi-rope connection, there will be a zero address 0 to address 15. Means we can connect 16 field devices together. But there is a problem in multi-rope. Not actually a problem. There is a different configuration for multi-rope connection. This red wire, that is the analog signal, that is 4 milliampere to 20 milliampere. In this case, this analog signal will be used to give the power to the field devices, not for the communication, not for getting the data from the devices. And in multi-rope configuration, we'll get the data, and we can send the data using the FSK signal, that is digital signal. So this is the difference between multi-rope configuration and point-to-point configuration. And in multi-rope configuration, we can connect 16 devices together using address 0 to address 15. So these are the benefit and most important features of Hart. It is a very simple design, and it is very easy to maintain and operate. It is also conventional with analog instrumentation, and it can work with both analog and digital communication. And there is a two options, that is point to point connection and multi-rope connection. And also this is sufficient response time, approx 500 milliampere millisecond. And also this is this does not depends on any vendor. We can and it is a vendor independent. We can use any devices from any vendor. So these are the most important features of Hart. Now coming to the next slide, this is the handheld device. This is the picture of handheld device, and it is called as secondary masters. It can be removable, and it is temporary. Okay, I already talked about this configuration, that is a PC, that is primary master, and this is secondary masters. Now coming to the oilless, before this slide I have already talked about some wired connection, okay, but in nowadays we are looking for some oilless connection, because if we use the oil, then maybe if when the disaster will come, then wire can be cut down or wire can be broken. So we are looking for wireless heart. So here you can see the benefits of wireless heart. It will reduce the installation cost, because there will be no oil. Or also it can monitor the process well, it can manage the asset, it can also control the field devices, and it can also regulatory compliance, and it is more secure, because in wireless communication there will be one security manager. Okay, so this is the overview of wireless heart communication. It is very much secured. It can protect the valuable information, and it also protect the wireless whole network, whole wireless network, and it is very easy to install. Okay, in this slide I will talk about the configuration of wireless network, wireless heart communication. Here in wireless heart communication there are three main elements are there. One is wireless field device, second is gateway, and third is network manager. In this picture you can see the diagram of the wireless heart network. These are the field devices. These field devices are connected with an access point, and this access point is connected with the gateway, and this gateway is connected with the host application, that is the master, that is the primary master. And in parallel with the gateway there is one network manager and one security manager. Okay, this network manager is basically designed for monitoring the status of the field devices and the whole network, and this security manager will think about the security of the wireless network and the security of the data. Okay, and when this host can send the data using gateway then access point, then the send the command using this gateway then access point then the field devices, and in reverse the field devices will send the data to the host applications. So this is the wireless heart network. These are some applications of wireless heart network. So we can use the we can manage the asset, we can diagnose the field devices, also we can get the status of the field devices, and we can monitor the smart field devices using this wireless heart application. And nowadays in conventional way we are getting more and more wireless rather than wire. So this is the wired connection. Here is the heart devices, field devices, and this is the master connection, master device, and it is connected using a twisted pair. Okay, this is the twisted pair, and this is 4 to 20 milliampere control loop. This is the wired connection, and in next slide you can see wired plus wireless heart adapter. Here and the field devices is connected with the PLC. This is the PLC using a wire. Also it can connect, it is connected with the host application wirelessly, and this is the gateway. So this is the architecture for both wired and wireless adapter, hard adapter. Now in conclusion we can say that in our era we are getting more smarter. We need some smart devices. So, and this heart communication protocol, it's free, and it is giving us it is giving importance of our smart devices, and also it is simple to design, easy to maintain, and easy to operate, and it is also works with analog and both analog and digital communication, and the response time is very good, and it is easy to implement, so we can go for heart communication protocol. Thank you everyone. Thank you.